And welcome back to the last session in today's Microsoft Virtual Academy Windows 8.1 Jumpstart. I'm your host, Ed Bott, and we're going to talk about some interesting technology in this session that maybe wasn't possible 20 years ago when the IT pro industry started. The traditional management of Windows networks involves fully managed workstations. You've got PCs, desktops, notebooks, they're domain joined, and you as the IT pro, the network administrator, can define what the policies are. But there's a new world out there now. Employees are bringing in their own devices, or you might even be supplying them with devices that simply aren't capable of being domain joined. It's mobile device management is the technical term for it. The more colorful term is BYOD, bring your own device. And in this session, we're going to talk about some of the interesting features in Windows 8.1 that allow you to maintain some loose control over your environment and protect the corporate assets and information that you have without having to fully manage those devices. With me today in the studio, I have Martin Booth. He's an expert in configuration manager in Windows Intune, and we're going to talk about a whole range of these features that are centered around the idea that IT is more about people now than it is about machines.
Yes, definitely, Ed, and thank you for that introduction. I wanted to start off by looking at kind of what we term as people-centric IT. We've seen in the past that IT management within the enterprise has been very focused on the devices. It's about that managed PC locked down in one flavor that everyone gets. We've seen a shift in the market now towards more a people-centric approach. So on the slide here, it talks about the four main areas that we need to look at. First and foremost, you have the users. Users are used to an idea of getting applications from app stores. They're used to customizing their devices with all the technology that's available in the home and from the consumer outlets, they're used to kind of doing things the way they want to with technology. The devices, we have a plethora of devices coming into the environment now. People are getting the latest, greatest tablet, they're using phones that they want to bring in and use for their work purposes. On the application side, we need to give people access to the apps, the tools they need to do their business. And then, of course, we have the data. This is the most critical piece for most enterprises. People want to make sure that data is secured, it's well managed, that it's only going out to devices where the risk profile is understood.
And in a lot of cases, that data is part of a managed and regulated environment. So if you're in the financial or the securities industry and you're governed by Sarbanes-Oxley, or in healthcare industry and you have to comply with HIPAA, that's not just important, it's legally required.
That's correct. So having data going out onto devices that are loosely managed with a high risk profile is maybe something you don't want to do with information that's subject to those kind of auditing and restrictions. So from the Microsoft perspective, we want to provide that platform of management, the access capabilities, and the protection for the data. And we look at that across three real areas. First, enabling the users, giving people access to what they need, unifying the environment, using the tools that people are used to using, that people use within the enterprise today, but taking it out to the cloud and the mobile devices, and then protecting the data. If I just pull up a slide that just highlights those three areas again, you can see some of the investments that we've made in at Microsoft around these areas. For enabling the users, we have access to resources through a company portal powered by Configuration Manager and Windows Intune, which is consistent across platforms, regardless of the type of device people are using. We have a simplified process for enrolling or registering the devices with the organization for management and authentication, and also allowing the users to synchronize their corporate data easily. On the Unify side, bringing the on-premise and the cloud-based environments together in a management console that's familiar for the IT pros, so Config Manager, bringing together both worlds there. Comprehensive settings management around controlling things like access to resources, as well as locking down the devices and making sure they meet your compliance needs. And then on protecting the data, once data is on the devices, we want to make sure that if the device is no longer being used for work, that that data can be removed, or if data is going down onto the device, that it's appropriately protected by something like rights management. So those are kind of the main pillars that we want to look at. And I want to walk through a number of demos around various aspects of the technology that we've got.
Okay, and I'm going to, you used the word devices in there. And I noticed on the previous slide, these aren't just Windows devices that we're talking about here.
That's correct.
I saw an Apple logo in there, and I saw the little Android robot in there as well. So in many of these scenarios, we're talking about devices that can span different platforms, right?
Definitely. We want to provide a consistent platform from a management perspective, regardless of what device the end user has. So some of the capabilities will vary by what the platforms can provide, but we do management of iOS, Android, as well as Windows Phone and Windows devices now. And that goes to the level of application delivery and things like that.
Now, having said that, today's session is about Windows 8.1, so we're going to be concentrating on Windows 8.1. And in fact, specifically, I think the demos that you have planned for us are about Windows RT 8.1.
I'm running all my demos on Windows RT, running 8.1 here, but they do apply to full Windows 8.1 as well. And I'll point out some of the places where similar things apply for iOS or Android as well.
And just to make clear, so for example, we could have a scenario for some of these things where a user is bringing in a laptop that they bought at their local big box store that's running the standard version of Windows 8.1, not professional, not enterprise, it's not managed, and yet they want to... They like that device, and they want access. They want to be able to do work from it, but they don't want to surrender control of it to you.
Yes, there's always this balance between people having access to the applications and data versus the control that IT has over it. So we want to give the tools to IT so that you can have lightly managed devices. So if somebody has a home PC or a laptop at home and they want access to some apps, they might have to put up with some management, but that gets them into having those applications rather than being fully domain joined and VPNing in and giving up all control over their home PC.
Got it.
Okay, so let's move to the RT device and I can take you through some of the demos here. So here's my Windows RT device. It's set up as my personal device here. There are two capabilities that I'm going to show first. Let me just unlock it again. There we go. I mentioned about the idea of registering and enrolling a device. These are two separate capabilities we now have in 8.1. If I go into the modern control panel in network, we have this workplace option here now. And there's two buttons. One says join and one currently says turn off. The top one, the join button, is the workplace join capability. So this registers my device with Active Directory. It's not a full domain join, but it's enough for the device to be authenticated by Active Directory. So as well as trusting the user credentials, we can trust that I'm coming in from a known device now. The second option, the one that currently says turn off, is the enrollment for management. I've actually already enrolled this device for management because that takes a few minutes to go through. I didn't want to waste time during this demo. So I've actually already enrolled for management there. But what I'm going to do now is just hit the join button for workplace join. This is going to take me out to a prompt for my credentials. I'm using my corporate credentials here that are federated using Active Directory Federation Services. I'll enter my super secret password. So it authenticates that I'm a valid user to register my device, connects to the workplace. This will put a certificate on the device and create a record in AD that matches the device. So we can see my device has now joined this workplace network. Because my device has joined the workplace network, that record in AD can now be used for authentication. So I've got a SharePoint site on my extranet. If I go to https sharepointcontoso.demo.com, this is a SharePoint site that is restricted around my user, so only certain users have access. I'll enter my credentials here and the password, and I'll type the password correctly. And this is going through validating my password, but actually in the background as well, it's validating the workplace join piece. So if I was coming from a PC that wasn't workplace joined, I'd get an access denied message there.
And so the scenario where this is really important is if your corporate credentials were compromised, somebody had your login name, but they didn't have your machine, there's not much they could do. They could try to log in, but they'd be rejected because they don't have that certificate that's on this machine.
Correct. They could. It can be used as a second factor of authentication.
And conversely, somebody who steals, you leave this machine and somebody steals this machine, they don't have your login credentials, so there's not much they can do with that machine by itself as far as access to the corporate network goes.
Correct.
Okay.
So that was workplace join. And I mentioned this device is already enrolled for management. So I can get access to things like websites through the normal authentication methods there with the workplace join authentication as well. But what about other applications that I want to get access to? I've got the company portal application installed on here. So this is my hub for getting access to all the apps that IT want to provision to me. I get a nice rich interface here, kind of similar to the Windows Store experience, where I can go through and look at the catalog of applications that are available to me as a user. So I can go through and look at the various categories, pull up the kind of applications that are provisioned to me here. I'm going to go and head back to the main screen here and pull up all apps. So we can see there's a number of types of apps that are available to me as a user here. I have an applications, Contoso applications web link here. This one's actually not an application to install, it's just a shortcut to a web page. So if IT just want to give me access to a web application, like a web-based CRM system, they could actually publish the link to that here. We can also publish applications that we've written we want to sideload to the device. Unfortunately, I don't have an example of that available on this device just at the moment. But if I've created my own modern application for Windows, I could publish it. The users would see it in this portal and be able to install it directly from here.
Now, there's some work that has to be done before that is possible. There's enabling sideloading. I don't want to get too distracted by this, but I think our audience would be interested in knowing what exactly you have to go through before you can enable your own custom-written line-of-business modern apps to run on a machine like this.
Yes, that's correct. I mean, you have to enable the device for sideloading of applications. So if you wanted to install an app from a USB stick or something like that, you'd have to turn on sideloading on the device. One of the beautiful things about the way we do the management with Configuration Manager and Windows Intune is that will actually activate the sideloading for you. So part of the enrollment for management switched on sideloading. So now applications can be published. I can retrieve them from the Windows Intune service via the company portal here, and they'll install down to my device directly.
Very nice.
The other type of application we have is apps that are in the public stores. So we can see things like the OneNote application here is actually already in the public store. So my IT department here want to share with me that that app is there and available, so I can quickly find the apps that are recommended to me for my company use. The other things I can see in the company portal are just things like my other devices. So I can go in and see this is the Surface device that I've got enrolled here. If I had other devices like a phone, maybe I've got an iPhone that I use that I've enrolled, I would also see that in the list here. So if I've lost a device, I can quickly come in here and do a remote wipe on it directly from this portal as well. And then the final thing you can see is the contact IT. So as a user, I can get quick access to my IT help desk and other resources if I do actually have trouble with this device.
Great.
So that kind of covered off the application delivery side of things and the company portal experience. One of the other things I mentioned was about synchronizing data. So we've seen access to web applications, we've seen line of business apps and getting apps through the company portal. I mentioned about getting data down to the device. One of the new capabilities we have with Windows 8.1 and Windows Server is a capability called work folders. This is a file synchronization technology that enables me to synchronize some of my data on the file server down to my devices. Even though they're not joined to the corporate network and not domain joined machines, I can still get access to that information on these.
Now, is this using the same infrastructure as the familiar offline folders feature that we know from previous Windows versions?
It's kind of building above and beyond that. It is a different technology to SkyDrive Pro, which is SharePoint based. It's different technology to SkyDrive, the consumer offering. It's still based on file shares and a replication of that file shared down to here, but it's going above and beyond what we had with offline files before. One of the things I can do with the company portal here is actually pull up a link here directly to work folders within my company portal. So you can see here, I've got, let me just zoom in on that. I've got the ability to set up work folders from the control panel here. And I'm just going to go and enter my corporate email address here. And this will go and automatically discover where my work folders server is. It's going to prompt me for my corporate credentials again.
And while you're doing that, as people can also see that you could have, you could supply your users with a URL where they could go and do this setup process instead, right?
The URL there is if you've put your work folders in a location that is not published. By default, it will look in DNS to see if it can find the record for the work folders server. If it can't find it, you can give it the URL to go to. You could also set that URL using group policy or through configuration manager and Intune management. Okay. So now I've got that set up. I can tap next on here. It tells me that there are some policies that I could perhaps have applied to my device here. One of the capabilities with work folders is encryption. So IT are requiring that the folder that comes down is encrypted on the device using the encrypted file system. We use a specific key associated with the company, which does mean that when we come to remove this device from management, selective wipe as we term it, we can actually break that key in the back end, which means the data is no longer accessible if it's left on the device. There's also things like the ability to require a password on the device. So let me just accept these policies and hit set up work folders. So this is going to go through synchronization and bring down the data that's within my work folders on the server already. I've got a couple of PowerPoint presentations and a PDF that were on my file server. They've now been replicated down, or in the process of coming down, over the internet. It's an HTTPS secured connection, of course, but they're synchronizing down to my device. We've got a message at the bottom here saying that sync completed. So that's pulling some data down from my corporate environment, and you can see the green color on these files indicates that they are actually encrypted using EFS. Of course, having data that's encrypted within the work folders is great, but what happens if somebody chooses to turn off that encryption for a specific file or they copy it to a USB stick? That encryption is not really going to help you in that scenario. So our solution for protecting the data in those situations is to use rights management. That way, the protection actually travels with the data. So rights management will wrap a data file in an encrypted envelope. And then wherever that file goes, if it's copied onto a USB stick or something, that protection goes with it as well.
And rights management can determine the user's ability to perform a whole variety of actions, right? Copy, send via email, print.
That's correct. You can set which kind of rights you want to allow through that management. One of the great capabilities that we've introduced with Windows Server is the ability to do file classification on the file shares and apply rules and actions to those files. So when a file is saved up to the file share, it can be scanned. If there is a certain pattern match, whether it's a keyword or a data format like a social security number, the server can automatically carry out an action on that file, such as applying rights management directly to that file. So let me show you an example of that in action here. I'm going to go ahead and create a new PowerPoint presentation in my folder here. Let's call it demo. And I will open that up in PowerPoint. I've got a very simple rule on my server backend here, where if the server scans and finds the word confidential in any document, it'll automatically apply rights management to it. So I'm going to save that file to the server. Well, I'll save it to my work folders, which will then get replicated up to the server. So we can see I've got my demo file here. If I just refresh that, we can see, if I just zoom in a bit and move across, we can see it's 30K in size because there's nothing really in that file. So what happens is work folders will synchronize that file to the file server. The file server will scan it because it's a new file, it's been edited and updated.
Right.
We'll look for the rules, it'll find the match on the word confidential and apply rights management to that. that file, because it's changed on the server, will then get replicated down through work folders back down to my client. So if I just drop back out of that, zoom in, and let's refresh that. Okay, it's not quite done it yet, so let me see. Yeah, it's currently syncing the file, in fact. There we go, the sync's completed. If I go back and refresh that window, you can see the file now is 160K in size. So you can see the size change, that's due to the wrapper that's around it. So if I drop back out and go and launch that in PowerPoint, first thing it tells me, configuring the computer for rights management. So I'll enter my password. This will authenticate me with the rights management service and go and open that. And you can see here, we've now got the view permissions and rights management is applied to this file automatically. As a user, I didn't have to do anything for that. It automatically carried it out. The rules were controlled by my IT organization, so they know that this data is safe and secure.
And that could be done on an ad hoc basis as well. You could say, you know, all files for this user should be protected, should have rights management applied in a specific way, or this individual file, regardless of whether it matches a rule, I want this file to have rights management applied to it.
Correct. The engine we use behind it is actually incredibly flexible. It works in two halves. One is the file classification engine, which is the rules, for instance, the rule for the searching for the word confidential, which classify the file as a certain type, and then you have the actions that get carried out based on that classification. So you can set them up however you wish and carry out whatever kind of actions you wish to carry out.
Great, so you've done a pretty good job at this point of making sure that you can't do dangerous things, too many dangerous things with those files.
That's true. Now that PowerPoint is rights management encrypted, if I take it from here and put it on a USB stick, that rights management encryption goes with it as well. Okay. One of the other things I ought to mention while I'm here talking about work folders, that capability is currently Windows 8.1 specific. We have announced that we are going to be bringing it back to Windows 7, and there is going to be an iOS version of it as well. We haven't announced the timing for that just yet, but we are working on it and it will be coming.
Great.
The enrollment for management and the company portal is available across all the platforms I said we could manage as well. So iOS, Android, Windows Phone, and Windows as well. So we get into a position where we've got a much more consistent story for management and capabilities across all the platforms as well.
Great.
One of the other areas I wanted to mention as well was the ability to provide remote desktop capability. It might be for your enterprise that you don't actually want your data to come down to the device itself. It could be you've got some systems where you want the data to remain within the data center. So it can't escape, it's going to stay there, it's going to be fully audited, fully traced, and won't actually come down to these devices. So we have our remote desktop clients for these platforms as well. Let me drop back to the start screen here.
And in both Windows 8.1 and Windows RT 8.1, you have two remote desktop clients, right? There's the desktop remote sounds a little redundant, doesn't it? But the desktop remote desktop client, and then there's also the modern, more touch-friendly remote desktop client. Essentially, they're capable of doing the same thing.
Yes. Essentially, the original, what was the terminal services client, the desktop client for remote desktop, is still there, but we do have the modern application now as well, which fits nicely with the RT devices where people don't necessarily need to drop to the desktop. They can just quite happily launch the modern app and get their remote desktop through that. We have also recently released remote desktop clients for iOS and Android as well, available on the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store, which means that if you have got users that are doing bring your own device with iPads, they could actually have this remote desktop client and get access to their Windows applications, their remote sessions, remote apps from those devices as well.
Great.
So let me show you the remote desktop client in action here on my device. If I go and launch that, I've got an option here in the remote desktop client to say access remote app and data connections. So I've got a remote app set up within my corporate environment. Again, I enter my corporate email address and hit connect. It's found the resource feed that corresponds to my email address, so I'll say yes, I want to sign up for that. And again, it's going to prompt me to sign in.
And that was a one-time setup there, right? You're not going to have to do that every time.
Correct. This is a one-time setup, and I'll show you the results of what happens with the setup in a moment, which makes it even easier for the user. I'm going to hit remember my credentials for that. So this is going to go and look at my remote apps that I have available. You can see the message there. I've got one desktop and nine apps that are available. If I hit OK on that, I can see the list of applications I've got there. So those are the apps that are published out to me via remote app. I've also got the remote desktop on the left-hand side. The most interesting part of this, and the thing that I think is really cool for a lot of users, is if I go back to the start menu now and head across to the right-hand side, we can see these work resources that have now appeared, all these new icons here. These are the apps that have been published to me for my server, but I see them integrated directly into my start experience here as well.
And you could then pin them to your start screen?
Yeah, let me do that. I'm going to pick Internet Explorer here. This is the full Internet Explorer 11. So even though I'm using Windows RT, I could actually get access to a full desktop Internet Explorer session through this. I've pinned that to my start screen. If I go and hit to launch that, we can see the initial prompt say, do you want to connect? And this is going to go and start up my remote session to the server and run IE, but running it actually on the server side and exposing it to me just as if it was a local app. So
Now, one of the, of course, the huge advantage of this for somebody using a device that's running Windows RT 8.1 is that, you know, if I have a desktop app, I can't install it on this Surface device, but I can run it from a remote app package like that.
Correct. So any line of business app, any third-party app that you'd normally run on Windows, publish it as a remote app, use a remote desktop client on RT, and your users will still have access to that.
And they would also have access to it from any supported device or machine, so without having to install that device, without having to install that app on the local device that they're using. It runs, you do your work, you close it, it's gone.
That's correct. And again, as I mentioned, any data associated with that app is still living in your data center. It's not coming down to the device itself. So again, another way to protect your data and make sure things aren't escaping out on devices that are being brought into the environment.
Great.
So one other capability that I wanted to show on my company portal here, so you can see I've got my applications. I'm actually going to go ahead and just install this web link to my device. And we've talked about the work folders, so I've got some corporate data that's come down to this device as well. I mentioned the ability to selectively wipe a device. So as a user, if I've decided I no longer want to use this device for work, I want to remove all my work information from it, but keep all the personal stuff intact, I have the capability of doing that. I could do that from the company portal here with a remove option. I can also go back into my control panel, modern control panel, and remove it from here. So I'm going to do that in a second. One thing I wanted to point out is the administrator actually has the ability to do that as well.
Right.
So if I was an employee that left the company, the admin could actually go and do a selective wipe remotely from the admin console on the server, which would remove the corporate data from the device without me as the user having to do anything.
And the crucial thing there is that I think a lot of IT pros are used to having the fully managed device where they say, well, either we own it, and so we're going to take it back from you, and then we're going to wipe it clean, and we're going to pass it along to somebody else. But this is a different world that we're in now. And so you say, fine, you had corporate information on your own personal device. We're not going to touch anything else on your corporate device, on your personal device, except this corporate information, which is going to poof, go bye-bye.
Yes, and we're seeing more and more that people are using the latest, greatest tablet, quite happily wanting to use it for their work, and now we're enabling them to do that. The next great tablet comes along, I've got my Surface RT, there's Surface 2 coming along, I'm going to want to get that and use that for work. My RT probably be passed on to my kids. But if I want to do that, I want to remove the work data before I do it. So being able to do that in one go is a really key piece of functionality. So I'm going to do that on this device now. So in the modern control panel here, I've got the two options, leave to leave the workplace network. So I'm going to hit leave on that and turn off to turn off device management. Again, you get warnings saying that some applications could be removed if you do that. So that goes through. It looks at what apps were installed by the company portal and will remove those. And with modern apps where the data actually lives with the application, the data will go as well. It will also break the encryption key that we were using for work folders and remove the data associated with that. It'll also remove any policy. So if any restrictions were pushed down via Configuration Manager and Intune, those policy settings would be removed. That goes for things like certificates that have been provisioned to the device as well.
So during the workplace join portion, there was a certificate that was installed on the machine. That gets removed?
That's correct. In fact, if I go back into the browser now, actually let me just close the browser completely just to clean up and launch the browser again. If I go and hit that SharePoint site again, if the cookies have had time to expire, they haven't quite yet. When the cookies expire, next time I try and access this SharePoint site, it will actually come back and say your device is no longer registered, it's no longer workplace joined, and deny me access again to that site as the state it was before. The other thing to point out is the work folders piece. So if I go back to my desktop, let's pan back through the applications. If I go down and find Windows Explorer, if I look in my work folders location, it hasn't quite cleaned it up yet, but very shortly when the encryption keys, in fact, let's just check. Yeah, the encryption key's already broken, so it says I can't actually open those files anymore. So even though they're still present on the device, I can't actually read them. Oh, and while I was actually looking at it, it actually removed them.
Yeah.
So yes, the work folders data's gone, apps have gone. All the policy settings that were applied to the device have been removed.
But all of your personal data, all of your personal programs, all of your personal settings remain untouched.
Yes. So it's a pretty clean removal of corporate data, leaving your personal experience still fully intact.
Great. And almost all of this is new with Windows 8.1.
Yes, I mean, the capability of managing via Intune was available with Windows 8. The new thing we have with the Intune management with Windows 8.1 is this ability to manage it as a mobile device. So previously with Windows 8, you had the full Intune client, very similar to the full Configuration Manager client, or you had the RT-based style mobile management. With Windows 8.1, you can do the mobile device style management with both a laptop running Windows 8.1, 8.1 Pro, or you can do it with 8.1 RT devices as well.
And what if someone uses a separate mobile device management suite, something other than Windows Intune? Do they have access to any of these features?
They do. There are a number of other vendors out there with mobile device management solutions that are adopting 8.1 as a client. The client that we've got in here for enrollment is based on OMADM, the Open Mobile Alliance Device Management Protocol, which means any third party can develop based off those APIs to be able to manage this device over OMADM. And we have seen a number of vendors that do it. Of course, we want to make the experience best with Windows System Center together, but there are third party options out there as well.
Great.
And then kind of the work folders piece, you can do that if you're using another management solution that's not tied into Configuration Manager or Intune. And similarly, the workplace join is another separate feature. So it's not that you have to use all this together for it to work, but if you do have all the bits together, it works quite beautifully, better together.
There you go. Well, thank you very much for those demos.
Thank you.
And appreciate that. That wraps up the last of our sessions in the Virtual Academy Windows 8.1 Jumpstart today. I want to remind everyone out there that there is a satisfaction poll that you'll see on your screen, and we would be very grateful if you would take the time to fill out that poll and let us know what we did well and what you'd like to see us improve. And sessions that we had today, the five sessions that we had, will be available for replay later on. And the slides that were available with today's presentations will also be available for you to download. Thanks again to everyone. Thanks for everyone around the world for tuning in live and for watching the replay of it. And we'll see you later.